Bonjour everyone, Pentouf here today for a new amazing replay in which we have the pleasure of watching Starnador, and I hope I pronounced it correctly, and I didn't, Starnador, sorry, which is gonna play, who is gonna play, his Dracula. And before we start off even that video, I would suggest you to watch it from the beginning to the end, because as you can see, that guy right there has the pro avatar, which means that he's a Twister Cup player, or at least he participated into those tournaments, which means he's extremely high skilled, and therefore we will all have something to learn from his playstyle. So, now that being said, what can we talk about concerning the Dracula? The Dracula, guys, I think you already know what it is. No armor, an amazing gun, an amazing top speed, and that's basically what sums up the tank. We could combine that with an amazing gun depression, which allows you to be flexible on pretty much every single terrain, and that's something Starnador understood perfectly, because instead of going on the other side of the map, which is something I would have done personally, I like to go on the other side of the map because with this kind of mobility you have, you can play extremely aggressively, but he decided to take his distance, to be able to circle them. That's a proper tactic that works effectively with the Dracula. It's either you play aggressively, or you can wait in the back or try to circle like he's doing right now. That's what he does, and it's working pretty effectively. Maybe I wouldn't have tried this on the SU-100Y. I wouldn't have stayed in front of the enemy. I would have tried to go somewhere else, because the SU-100Y here completely had time to aim at him before shooting. Maybe he was hoping through a peekaboo to actually bounce the shell, or maybe don't even take it. But unfortunately, he took it anyway, which reduces quite a lot his HP, but it's not a problem. He still has a lot to go for. So there we go, he sneaks a good shot on the SU-100Y going at the top of this hill. I was surprised at first when I saw that shot, because I already watched that replay, so I know what's gonna happen. But with the SU-100Y, I thought it was gonna go straight on the KV-2, so I don't know if Starnador did it on purpose or not, but that was kind of a weird shot in my opinion. But it worked, and that's all that matters. You know, when you do an ace tanker, guys, it's not necessarily all about skill, you have to get a little bit of luck as well, which Starnador didn't have on that shot from the KV-2. 442 straight into his side of the turret. He only has 227 HP left. He gotta be careful. There we go, he takes his distance from the Panther, trying to circle around the rock, and what he's doing right now is extremely smart. He knows he has a better mobility than the Panther, and he's using that mobility to be able to sneak some shots on the Panther without the Panther being able to climb back on the Dracula. There we go for the shot. Unfortunately for him, he took one. The Panther, luckily for him, missed him, and now he's alone against five guys, and he's a one shot. Luckily for him, he managed to sneak a shot on the Panther, because as I told you, the mobility is insane, so even when you are going backward, you can still go faster than the Panther and escape your death. And now he has to deal with the rest of his opponents. His only way to win, in my opinion, right now, is that maybe they are going to push him one by one. If the enemies are not pushing one by one and he has to deal with five tanks all at once, it's impossible. Now it's reduced to 1v3, but he's still one shot. You gotta be careful. Luckily for him, the KV-2 doesn't have the best ever dispersion, so he can try something. Same for the Annihilator, which missed him. Now he goes for a second shot, and he has to go away. He knows he can't handle them. He has to move. The Annihilator is reloading for the moment, but as soon as he crosses, he will be done. And there is the KV-2 as well. Luckily for him, the amazing gun handling of the Dracula allowing him to sneak the shot, and he's gonna try out his luck on the KV-2. If I was the KV-2, I would have shot without waiting, because it's a Russian tank, RNG, Russian RNG, usually it allows you to get your shots straight in. And he was quite lucky on that one, still skilled because he tried some peekaboo, but I don't think it would have worked with every single KV-2 you are going to encounter in your entire Blitz career, which is kind of logic. Killing the KV-2 allowed him to escape from the Annihilator, and that's exactly what our friend is doing right now. He's going on the other side trying to see where the VK-3601H is, and it seems like either the guy is AFK or he died. He's not dead, so he's probably AFK. I like what he's doing right now. He knows he doesn't have any HP left. So instead of pushing through, trying to circle the Annihilator, which could be a valid tactic, don't mind me. Here instead, he tries to get his shots done from the bottom of the map. And that's possibly the best thing to do right now. There we go, and luckily for him, really luckily for him, he managed to bounce all the shells from the Annihilator. There we go, he waits for the Annihilator to try to cross. He sneaks the first shot, he goes for the second one, killing the Annihilator before this guy managed to reload. That was totally logic. We're now on 5 kills and there is only the VK3601H that he has to find. But we don't have a clue where the guy is right now. He's gonna try to find him out and you're gonna see that it's gonna take him not necessarily a long time, but as he's trying to find him, it's not really interesting for us to watch him finding out where the guy is, and luckily for him, he was AFK. He clutched a 1v5 game, obviously having a little bit of luck on the Annihilator shot and the KV2 shot and even the Panther shot, but hey, to get these kind of games, you have to be extremely skilled, but also extremely lucky. It worked well for him because 5.2k damage and 6 kills, and truly he deserves a video and an ace tanker. Congratulations, I guess you advanced a little bit on the lows of Sherman Evan because it allowed you to climb up to 5 parts. Not enough, you still have 210 to go for, as everybody else. But that was an amazing replay and I thought it definitely needed a video on that channel. So to sum up, what is important to understand when you are low life and dealing with multiple enemies, you want to take them out one by one, not all in groups, because you're not going to be able to clutch it. You want to take your distances, you want to take positions from which enemies will struggle penetrating you or even hitting you. That was the case against the KV2, against the Panther, and against the Annihilator. That's extremely important because that's your only way, as you're low HP, to kind of avoid taking the shots. And finally, use your mobility if you have it. Hopefully you enjoyed, guys. If that's the case, feel free to subscribe, like, and share. And I'm gonna see you soon for a new video, probably sometime. See ya.